it a lot for the wins.
Start your week by installing your game plan.
Top once again, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the air. Now we on top once again. Ain't love if it ain't get it away from me. Who you gonna jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gonna pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up. Did it. Never enough. I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the wheels suspended. I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who is the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You better so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top yeah. Once again. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah.
Hey.
I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the
today, from Soldier Field in Chicago. Preseason of EA Sports. Mitchell Trubisky and the Chicago Bears taking on Baker Mayfield and the Cleveland Browns.
Bit of a sloppy track here at Soldier Field. Still getting some of the wraparound rain bands of a low-pressure system that's hovered over Chicago the last couple of days. Just a short time ago, this crowd loud enough to shake the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football indeed in Chicago as their guys get set to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. And I don't think from what we saw down on the field before the game, there's any doubt. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. First carry now for David Montgomery. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
The ball carrier.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
On second down, it's Montgomery. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. And he will have the Bears first down. At least it appears that way. And he got it by maybe the length of a football. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive. Couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized. And the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll throw it with Trubisky. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Oh, why are we doing
that? A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. And Anthony Miller. 26 yards, and the Bears have taken the early lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions, and whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They'll start on the ground with Montgomery. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
Nice gain there by the second-year runner out of Iowa State, David Montgomery, who often finishes his runs moving forward and knocking defenders back. He finished tied with Josh Jacobs for the most carries by a rookie last year. But what the Bears need from him? Improve on his 3.7 yards per attempt. If he gets that up into the fours, look out. He can control a game with his running.
First down, they run again. Here's Montgomery. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery, 65 yards. And the Bears have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touch. The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down.
Looks like they went for the combo play there. Nice ample gain on the ground on the previous play. Going for the big shot on that one, unsuccessfully.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. He'll take a shot for the end zone. The Browns D locked in on third down. Brings up fourth.
And there shouldn't be any surprise at all when we watch him flash his arm. Easy motion, easy action.
And they won't try and pooch it. It's a fake. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. That goes for 15 yards on the fake, a first down. And a lot of fist pumps right now on that sideline.
I'm not sure that the surprise was that they actually faked it. That's classic territory to go ahead and do it. The surprise to me is that they were successful. I'm not sure the defense was really prepared.
And now they're going to keep the drive alive here. Really big play on the fake punt. First and 10, it's Trubisky. Oh, nearly a disaster there on the check down. But they'll get it back.
Montgomery.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Now Trubisky going to give this to Montgomery. And they'll get this down to the 10. Through one corner, 14-7, our score.
Bears 14. Brown 7.
Go, go, go. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them. They did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
On second and 11 now, Foles. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Tariq Cohen there to make the grab, and the Bears will extend their lead. So simple math here. The first half, they've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down.
Now, following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to float this over the middle. And this is caught at the 20. Touchdown, Chicago! Javon Wims, 60 yards. And the Bears will add on to their lead.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Now Foles. He's going to loft one deep left side. He's got a man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
There's certainly a lot of quality receivers on this team, so he's no lock to make this squad. But the way he's got to do it, make every routine catch that comes his way, and mix in some of the big-time ones like the one we just saw there.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Able to break through that initial contact and winds up getting about 3 there. It's second down. We remind you, coming up at halftime, Charles, you want to wait and enhance your Saturday? I've got the thing just for you. It's the coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando to take us through the weekend in the NFL. Javon Wims, the intended target, and it'll bring up third down.
Brings up third down and 7.
Here's Foles. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
His kick is no good.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Foles. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 35. A big play there just before halftime. And even 40 yards.
Able to hit on a big play right there in the 2-minute drill. Now they've got a chance to use all the remaining clock and build on their lead right before halftime.
So So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Javon Wims, ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game as the Bears push further out in front.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll have a first down past the 40 as he'll get this one up to the 44-yard line. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Chicago. A big play there. 56 yards. And the Bears will extend their lead.
Well, I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it.
Both offenses. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
And that's the big fella's MO right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Bulls on the handoff. Here's Cohen. And some room to roam now. The 20, 10, and he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Tariq Cohen, ready for the regular season with his second touchdown of the game. And the Bears will add on to their lead.
Sometimes running plays hit or break so fast, there's no reaction time from the secondary. So I've got to give credit to the offensive line for creating that hole so suddenly.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And finally taken down at the 35-yard line. That one 28 yards on the ground. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. That's going to be caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Back-to-back plays of right around 30 yards, and the field position has totally been flipped.
Well, he's certainly trying to earn his way into some more looks in the offense once the regular season heats up. If he continues to make plays like that, I think QB1 will look his way a little more often once the regular season begins.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line. Jacob Phillips. He's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss. This is Cohen. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bears continue to pour it on.
Well, three scores in this game, I think that deserves some type of a broad gesture. I know in hockey, that's called a hat trick and people throw their hats out on the ice. What about us? What can we do for this guy?
Well, if I'm his teammates, I'm buying him a little steak dinner tonight, right? At least a skirt steak, probably a filet.
Oh, you're going big. I like that.
Yeah, I mean, skirt.
I mean, skirt steak. Come on. You can't give the guy a skirt steak.
Offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues.
Number 29.
Larry Ogunjobi there to make the tackle.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now. And here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
The Bears on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Just bowling over tacklers. 3rd and medium, they opted to run instead of pass, and it worked. 1st down.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on 3rd down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, 3rd down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a 1st down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
So a 1st and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 39-yard line. Now Cohen. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Andrew Sendejo in on the stop.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their targets.
Well, where our booth is here, we can see all of the writers to our left. And their post-game stories, Charles, they have been filed for some time because this game, boy, is it lopsided.
Yeah, we can see our guy Scoop. He's even got his fedora tipped over his face. I think he's taking a nap now.
So this offense will head back out there. Already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. 1st down, a run with Cohen. And he's got some space here. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And let's not forget he had the receiving touchdown earlier. Now a trio of rushing touchdowns. Quite a performance.
Diversification, that's all you can talk about. His ability to do everything leaves him on the field.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. A 2nd broken tackle. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters.
Don't worry about it, baby. I ain't worried about it.
They are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee.
So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. And they'll get him down up past the 15. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on this.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. The Bears get the win at home.